We've already seen how the chain rule can help us find antiderivatives, right? That method's called u-substitution. I want to do some more messing around with the chain rule and integration. In particular, let's see what we can do with the chain rule and the endpoints of integration.
Well, here's an example to play around with. If I take the integral from 0 to x of sine of t dt, well, that's something, but let's think about the derivative of this with respect to x. And by the fundamental theorem of calculus, this is sine of x. The fundamental theorem of calculus is the derivative of the accumulation function is the integrand.
What if that upper endpoint were a function of x?
What I'm asking is, what if this endpoint weren't x anymore, but some function g of x, right? Then this wouldn't be sine of x anymore, it'd be something else.
So to analyze this, let's define a function f.
So that function will be given by this rule. F of x is the integral from 0 to x of sine t dt.
Now, what would it mean if we replace that right-hand endpoint, instead of being x, if we replace that with g of x?
So that would mean that I want to think about f of g of x, right? What's f of g of x? So that's the integral from 0 to g of x of sine t dt. And specifically, right, what I want to know is, what's the derivative with respect to x of f of g of x?
That's just the chain rule.
So let me just write down the chain rule. The derivative of f of g of x is the derivative of f at g of x times the derivative of g.
So what does it mean in this specific case?
Remember, in this case, f of x is the integral from 0 to x of sine t dt. So the derivative of f, by the fundamental theorem, is sine of x. And that means that the derivative of f of g of x, well, that's just sine, the derivative of f, at g of x times the derivative of g.
Let's make it even more concrete. Let's say that g is the squaring function.
Let me write that down. So if I'm making g the squaring function, then the derivative of g is just 2x. And in that case, the derivative of f of g of x is sine of g, which is x squared, times the derivative of g, which is 2x.
So let's write down our final answer in this specific case. So
the final claim is that the derivative of the integral from 0 to g of x, which in this case is x squared, of sine t dt. This is the derivative with respect to x of f of g of x. This is sine of x squared times 2x. And this statement we can get by combining the chain rule and the fundamental theorem of calculus.